This week, our update is going to be about a different virus, the influenza virus. For the last few weeks and months, the COVID virus has been the shiny new kid on the block, and it's taken all the limelight. But we want to talk about the influenza virus as we're coming up into the winter flu season. This infection still causes quite severe illnesses, hospitalizations, and even deaths. And in actual fact, last year there was at least 18,000 people that were admitted into hospital due to influenza. Normally that's not a serious problem for our healthcare system, but in this kind of pandemic, what we really want to do is minimise the amount of people who are going to hospital for influenza and save the beds for COVID patients. Back to COVID for a moment. Only a few short weeks ago, our rate of infection was doubling every 3 days. Things looked dire, and modelling that came out just in the last day or so showed that up to 90% of people in Australia could be affected, and that our hospital systems would have collapsed under the load of people all needing healthcare at the same time. Then flattening the curve entered into our vocabulary, and we all learnt about social distancing with the aim of reducing transmission and keeping the number of infections and the rate of infections to what our hospital system could cope with. We should probably give ourselves a bit of a pat on the back, because we are making a difference and everyone is doing a good job, or at least 90% of you seem to be doing a good job. However, the flattening of the curve has thrown up an interesting situation with regards to timing. Flu season normally peaks at around August and September, and this also looks like it could be the time that the government does start relaxing some of those social restrictions and maybe even some travel restrictions. It's a point where we have to be very careful, because there is the real possibility that you could, as we're starting to get a bit of freedom, a bit of normality, we could be hit with a situation of people getting both COVID and an influenza infection at the same time. Given that these are both quite severe respiratory infections, the last thing we need is for people to be ending up in hospital having not one, but both of these infections. Now that you know there is a risk, how do we reduce the risk? I'll give you a very short answer, as in, if you are over 65, our strong recommendation is that you get the flu vaccine and get it very soon. Being over 65, you do fall into a higher risk category, and COVID seems to have a more severe effect on the elderly in our population. Anyone over 65 is entitled to a free flu vaccine through the National Immunisation Program. These free flu vaccines are distributed to both GPs and also pharmacies. If you go to a GP surgery, you won't be charged for the flu vaccine, because the GPs have the ability to charge you through Medicare consults. With a pharmacy, unfortunately, we don't have that ability, and so we do have a small charge of $10 to go towards covering our costs of providing what we think is a very valuable and convenient service to people, whether they are over 65 or under 65. Why do we strongly recommend that the over 65s get a vaccination? Well, as you get older, just like everything else, your immune system gets a little bit sluggish and a bit tired, and the response that it can give you is not as strong as what used to happen in a healthy young adult. The manufacturers of vaccine realize that this occurs, and what they do is they try to make the vaccines for elderly people much stronger. It's for this reason that we ask you, when you come in, whether you are over 65 or under 65, so that we know whether to give you the stronger vaccine. Last year there was a bit of confusion, because the over 65's vaccine only contained 3 strains of influenza virus and the under 65's contained 4. But this year both vaccinations are exactly the same in the strains that they will cover you for. So be assured that you are getting the same as everyone. You're just going to get a slightly, one that's got a little more oomph to get your immune system working well. Okay, so we've covered the over 65s and we're saying you definitely should get a vaccine. There are two other groups that I actually want to highlight. One of those groups is the people who are under 65 but also have a chronic health condition. With these people, one of the startling statistics is that they are 40 times more likely to die of influenza than a young healthy adult. I was pretty shocked at that stat, and unfortunately only 42% of people with a chronic health condition under 65 actually bother getting a flu vaccine. This year I think might be the year that I would say that it's time to get one if you need to. The second group I'd like to highlight is our frontline workers, both in healthcare and in other essential services. Given the pandemic, it's very important that people get to stay at their jobs, and even if you're young and healthy and you're a delivery driver or you work at a supermarket or, you know, you're a pharmacy worker or you work anywhere where what you're providing is essential for people to live. When you come into the pharmacy to book, please let us know that you're a healthcare worker or an essential services worker. We will definitely give you priority if there's a lack of vaccines or if there seems to be not enough vaccines to go around, because we obviously appreciate the help and that you're putting yourself on the line. Currently, less than 50% of healthcare workers get a flu vaccine each year. If you know someone that works with the sick or the chronically ill, what we want you to do is give them a bit of a prod and say, come on, it's time. Our own teams, we practice what we preach, and we have given flu vaccines to our staff at both Nourish and at Dunsborough, so you can also be assured that they won't be passing the flu on to you. One of the questions we get asked in the pharmacy all the time is, when is the best time to get a flu vaccine? Now, normally we would say that given the peak of the season is in August and September, that April, May is generally the best time, as you will get at least 6 months immunity before it starts to diminish. However, this year there's a couple of confounding factors in that. And the first one is that there is a hyper demand for flu vaccines at the moment. I don't know if you've seen the news today, but apparently pharmacies have vaccinated more people in 3 weeks than they did for the whole of 2019. The other reason is that, as reported by the health department, WA hospitals have been relatively quiet, apart from COVID patients, but relatively quiet with regards to respiratory illnesses. This may tempt people to think that if they're socially isolating and they aren't seeing people, then do they really need the flu vaccine? And it is a good question. If you're going to be around someone who's immunocompromised, pregnant, over 65, or with a chronic health condition, then maybe you might consider getting immunised so that you will also act as protecting them from the virus as well. Another question we often get asked too, and all people tell us anecdotally, is that they got the flu from the flu vaccine, or that they wonder if they can get the flu from the flu vaccine. That isn't possible, but I'll explain that a little bit. When the flu vaccine is produced, the virus is grown, and then it's purified, and then it's chemically killed. Once it's chemically killed, it's broken up into little pieces like a jigsaw puzzle. And what they do is they put little pieces of the jigsaw into the vaccine. And that vaccine then, when it's injected into you, your body recognizes these little pieces as being foreign and starts that second line immunity where it builds up antibodies to that particular little piece. Unlike Humpty Dumpty, it can't be put back together again. And when the little pieces of virus don't magically form into a whole virus again, and they can't replicate. So this is why scientifically it's very it's impossible to get the flu from this. However, there are two scenarios that I want to go through, and these tend to be the reasons why people think that they have get the cold or the flu at the time they get the injection. One of the things that can happen is if you're unlucky, you may be getting symptoms of a cold or a flu around about the same time that you actually get your flu injection. And so you've put two and two together, and it seems like that's what's happened to you. And we can understand that. But unfortunately, I think that's just a coincidence. The second reason, and the reason I think most is the reason that most people feel, is that you will get some tenderness in your arm where you've had a flu vaccine, and sometimes people get a bit of a lump and some soreness for a couple of days. Some people even complain about feeling just a little bit fluey, a little bit off, a little bit tired, and sometimes even a sniffle. What this is that your immune system has already kicked in. And what is happening is your general first line immunity, so that's not the immunity that recognizes the flu vaccine, that's just your general immunity, has picked up that there is something foreign there, and it's sent the troops in to start working. So in fact, this is a good tick for your immune system. And I'd be saying, yay, that's good, you're doing well. Lastly, I just want to give you a rundown of our immunisation service, vaccination service this year. Normally we offer a walk-in service where it's very convenient and you can just pop in any time and a pharmacist will be able to help you with a vaccination. But unfortunately, in this time of where we're in a pandemic situation, we've had to change the way that we do things, and we've changed to an appointment system, and we hope you appreciate why we've made these changes. By sticking with scheduled appointments, what happens is we can spread out the flow of patients coming in and minimise any cross-infection and spread of any kind of illness, not only just influenza. By keeping the numbers inside the shop down, we also are following the rules that have been suggested with how many people should be in enclosed spaces. When you do come for an appointment, we will give you a form to fill out and ask you to sit in our waiting chairs, which are outside the pharmacy, and fill out that form for us. Then you will be brought into the pharmacy, where the pharmacist, who will be wearing a mask and take you into the consult room, they will give you the injection within a 2-minute time frame, and then you are able to go outside and sit on our chairs again, waiting for the observation period of 15 minutes after your injection, just to make sure that everything is okay and you've suffered no adverse effects. The 15-minute time gap between patients allows us to follow some strict cleaning and disinfecting procedures between each patient. We're very focused on reducing your chance of infection, and this is a priority for us in offering this service to you. We appreciate your patience and understanding, and this is one of those times where we ask you to turn up exactly on your appointment time. There's no brownie points for being early, because it'll also avoid people waiting outside and forming queues. If you would like to book a flu vaccination through the pharmacy, the Dunsborough pharmacy will be the one that is doing all the flu vaccines. What you need to do is either call us on the telephone or come in and let us know, and we can put you on our waiting list, and we will, as we work through our list, we will space everyone out over the next few weeks to make sure that you do get the flu vaccination. So that's it from me for this week's update. I hope you found this information to be of some use to you. Thank you for watching through to the end, of course. Please contact our pharmacists if you have any questions about anything that we have said in this video, or that I've said in this video. And till next update, take care and stay safe.